In order to find the projection of force F1 on the line of action of F2, we can utilize the dot product between the force vector F1 with the unit vector of F2. So to start, force F1 needs to be converted into its Cartesian form, meaning that we need to identify its x, y, and z component. Since the vector is given in the 3D space, first of all, it is projected along the x, y plane by taking the cos 30 function, whereas the sine 30 function will project it along the negative z direction. Now the 30 cosine 30 vector needs to be further resolved along the x and y component, meaning that if we take the cosine 30 of this vector, it will project it along the y axis, whereas the sine 30 is going to project it along the x direction. Once we have each one of these components, we can represent it in terms of I, j, and k component. Here the I, j, and k are representing the unit vector along the x, y, and z axis respectively. Simplifying, we are getting the value of 12.99i plus 22.5j minus 15k. Once we have F1, let's figure out our unit vector of force F2. So there the force F2 is making an angle of 60 degrees with the y axis and 60 degrees with the z axis as well. However, the angle with the x axis is unknown. So first of all, let us solve for this angle alpha. As we know, cos square alpha plus cos square beta plus cos square gamma is equals to 1. Plugging in the value of beta and gamma equals to 60, we can simplify this and get the value of alpha. Here we are going to utilize the negative 0.707 terms to calculate the alpha, as it is greater than 90 degrees in this case. So the value of alpha is coming as 135. Once we have all the direction cosine of this force, we can write the unit vector by taking the cos function of each one of those angles. So our unit vector F2 is coming as negative 0.707i plus 0.5j and plus 0.5k. Finally, let's go ahead and take the dot product between the force vector F1 and the unit vector of force F2. Now for the dot product, we know that I dot I, J dot J, and K dot K is equals to 1, whereas the dissimilar components like I dot J or J dot K will give us the value of 0. In other words, the I components will be multiplied together, then the J components will be multiplied together, and finally the K components will be multiplied together. This gives us our final value of negative 5.44 pounds. Here the negative sign is indicating that the sense is opposite to the direction of force vector F2.